You are looking quite confused.
I've been cooking with potatoes for a really long time, and I've never known the difference between them.
You don't need to be embarrassed about not knowing the different varieties. But what you do need to know is there are two types of potato. There are floury and there are waxy.
So how do you know if a potato is waxy or floury?
The easiest way, really, is to tell by their size. Typically, the smaller potatoes are waxy and the larger potatoes are floury.
Which potatoes do you use for which food?
Why don't we take some and go and find out?
All right, load up.
Thank you.
We head to Maker's Test Kitchen to get to the root of this potato puzzle. But before we cook, Maker has one more tip to make sure we haven't mixed up our flouries and our waxies.
So if you get yourself one of those, Cherry, and one of those, and have a go at peeling off the skin with your thumb.
OK. So that's coming off quite easily.
Exactly. Waxy potatoes have thinner skin, which means their skin will rub off more simply. Okay. Compare that to the other one and see what you find.
That doesn't come off at all easily. So that's much thicker.
Absolutely. So a floury potato has a thicker skin typically.
Now we're clear what we've bought, I want to know the best way to cook them. We're testing three family classics.
We're going to do some roasties, we're going to do boiling potatoes, and we're going to do mashing. So you're going to be dealing with the King Edwards. They're a really great floury potato. And I'm going to be using the Charlotte, which is this lovely waxy potato.
It's a potato off.
Let's see which one wins. We're going to start off roasting, so get peeling, Cherry.
Oh, no, Maker, that's so mean.
The biggest difference between these two rivals is on the inside.
Floury potato typically has about 20 to 22% starch in it, and a waxy one is far less.
The cells of my floury spuds are more tightly packed with starch than the waxies.
Brilliant.
Ta-da. Ooh, there they go. They're going to be good. There it is. All right. Do your thing, King Edwards.
Let the best one win.
45 minutes later, our competing roasties come out of the oven.
Here we go. Let's see.
Oh, wow.
Golden perfection.
Hey there, good looking.
Shall we see how these are? These, I mean, God, they look amazing.
I mean, so delicious. Floury, soft, but crispy on the outside.
The starch granules in my King Edwards have expanded in the cooking process, forcing open the spud cells and creating a light, fluffy texture. What about Maker's waxy Charlottes?
They're quite dense.
Exactly.
They have 6% less starch, so they don't soften as much and produce a harder roasty with a drier feel.
If I was looking for a nice, traditional roast, I'd be disappointed.
So far, it's floury's 1, waxy's 0. On to the second test, boiling.
Carefully.
After 20 minutes in boiling water, it's clear that my floury King Edwards just aren't the right choice here.
I seem to have a kind of potato soup.
Exactly, because what happens with a floury potato when it cooks is that the cells pop open and it keeps on taking in all that water and they completely fall apart. Whereas the waxy ones, they don't let as much water in when they're cooking, so they stay in much better shape.
I think that's one all.
One all.
Now for our final test, mash, where the spud has been squashed, releasing the starch granules.
Oh, I don't want to be offensive, but that looks like wallpaper paste. It's so gluey.
It is, isn't it? That is what you get if you make a mash with a waxy potato. And that was my Charlotte potato. And you end up working it so hard to get it smooth that you've effectively made potato glue.
Waxies need so much pounding to open the cells, the released starches end up matting together.
So we're back to your nice, fluffy King Edward potatoes. Cook them until they're just about to fall apart, but not waterlogged. And you've got good mash.
But for perfect mash, Maker has one last trick up her apron.
It is a ricer, and basically it is designed to work that potato as little as possible.
In the ricer, the tater cells are gently broken apart rather than smashed open. Less force produces a fluffier texture.
You can see how smooth it is already, yes, without putting much work in.
Right.
So you just want to stir in the butter, milk and whatever flavourings, and you're done.
Let's have a taste. Perfectly seasoned, it's smooth, but it's still got a nice kind of grainy potatoiness. That is the perfect mash.
2-1 to you.
Game, set and mash to my King Edwards.
I've learnt so much today. I feel like I could do a PhD in potatoes now.
Armed with this new knowledge, I'll make sure I choose the right spud for the right job.